celebrate how well-rounded these students of gospel are. The musicians you're hearing tonight make up nearly all of our high school. Many were heavily involved in athletics and or pep band for many evenings this past week. They are also the same students that make up our honor roll, scholars bowl team, FFA, FCCLA, theater, and forensics groups, and I could go on. These students do many things well and are learning the value of becoming well-rounded people. And it doesn't happen by accident. At a time when other small districts are paring down their number of music teachers and creating class schedules that make choosing music classes difficult for students, our district continues to support music education and its benefits to students' overall growth. Pardon me while I step on my soapbox and preach to the choir a little bit, no pun intended. Here are some quick reminders that highlight music's importance in our schools. These are taken from the Kansas Music Educators Association website. Music and the arts connect subjects across the curriculum. Music demands excellence. Music education connects students and communities. We're doing that right now. Solutions to world problems are dependent on creative thinking and problem solving. Skills intentionally taught in music and other arts. The arts stimulate economic development and community infrastructure. The arts prepare students for the 21st century by teaching innovative thinking, problem solving, and collaborative skills. The arts build bridges among communities and people. And the arts improve the quality of life in our communities by increasing civic engagement. There's great variety among all music tonight, instrumental and vocal. Coming up, you'll hear arrangements of favorites from throughout history, as well as newer pieces that bring energy and excitement, and maybe some will be new to you. I hope we can thrill you and interest you tonight. We're going to do our Elviata 3 songs here as a fluid trio, so if you can help us out with no applause between, if you can remember, we say thank you. Please enjoy. So we've had a lot of highlights this semester at the full high school choir. Some of them include attending the Sing My Soul Festival at Bethel College with other various area choirs. We've had some workshops with Russell Agee from Heston College, Henry Waters from Bethel College, and Amy Ives from New High School. We've had some great guest musicians, chiefly Josue Koidik will join us in a second, and Mr. Gerard Dunn, our high school social studies teacher, will join us in a sec, as well as a successful online choir event at the October Harvest Festival with 50 singers and 6 current or former gospel teachers. In addition to that, we've had 3 singers accepted in a district choir who are all 3 anxiously waiting the state results, which have not come out yet. Our first piece, Noel, has text in the African Kituba dialect. It is a bright, rhythmic piece that captures the feeling of a tribal celebration as it expresses the excitement of Christmas. Brayton, Cheyenne, and Ellie will provide a rhythmic underlaying, and the opening call and echo will be provided by Jackson, Riley, Jake, Eli B., Levi, and Adam. We hope you enjoy Noel.
Noel! Noel! Noel!
We'll be joined by Josue Koidick on fiddle. He's a junior at Bethel College and an outstanding violinist as well as fiddle player. Josue joined us on our fall concert, and we're really excited to have him back again. Eli's going to give us a bit of a spoken introduction to what this arrangement is all about.
Brightest and Best is a lively arrangement of the study of American hymn tune Star in the East, with the text by Reginald Ebert. A banjo-inspired piano accompaniment provides sparks while the tune is presented in unison on verse 1, in canon on verse 2, and adorned with mirrored counter melodies on verse 3. The homophonic four-part refrains grow in intensity, culminating in a dramatic a cappella outburst. We hope you enjoy Brightest and Best.
For our next piece, Joy to the World. The title and text are about the only similarities between it and the classic melody that many of you probably know. This is a rock gospel arrangement. I'm really excited to be joined by Mr. Gerard Dunn on electric bass and Traven Edwards on drums. Both have added a ton to this piece, and they really make it rock. The only challenge is we can't let them rock too much because they can't cover up a choir. So it's not something you do every day when you add these electrified instruments and big trap set to choir pieces. It's been a nice challenge, but a fun challenge. I hope you enjoy it. set here for this next piece, I'd like to welcome Josue back to the stage. This next piece, called Peace, Peace, is a partner song that fits perfectly with Silent Night. During verse 2, we invite you to sing the melody of Silent Night, if you so wish, alongside us. And it really, hopefully, feels like alongside us as we come out there and join you and surround the audience. And I think this can be a nice, special moment for us all to feel like we're all joining together in song. So I'll give you a big cue when Silent Night is approaching on verse 2. Time for our annual tradition of inviting all that are interested to join us on stage for the community singing of Handel's Hallelujah Chorus. This has been a tradition at the Winter Concert since around the late 1970s, which dates back to the tenure of past director Jared Taves. Give or take a few years now, we tried to go deep into the history books, find the exact date. We're pretty sure that some of our sheet music copies are still the original copies from the 70s, definitely a little bit yellow. We'd like to fill the stage with many of you. Come now, please make your way up. If you choose to stay in the audience, it is a traditional custom to stand during the Hallelujah Chorus. The origins of this ritual, standing during the Hallelujah Chorus, are debated. But the most widely accepted theory is that during the premiere of Messiah, that this work was with it, King George II stood up during the chorus, and since it was considered good etiquette to stand when the king stood, the audience followed suit. Others debate that he was just tired of hearing 2 hours of music in the oratory before that, he just needed to stand. I don't know what it is. Some debate. Whatever the reason, the tradition has lasted, and we invite you to join in the age-old tradition of standing during the Hallelujah Chorus. And we're still trying to come and join us. If you are nervous that you'd be the only one, you see you're not the only one. There's still time. We could use a few more altos. I'm especially appreciative and enjoying the fact that there's young and old up here, and truly multi-generational performance here. All right, it's pretty fun. Thank you everybody for attending tonight. We wish you festive season, family and friends, and all the joy in the world. Thank you so much for coming out and supporting us. Have a great rest of your week. Thank you.